Hello friends, welcome you all. Today we are going to learn about the different insect pest population or insect pest management in pigeon pea or red gram, or also called as tur in Marathi and arhar in Hindi. Okay, here the tur is most important pulse crop in India as well as in the world. Here on the tur crop there are the number of major and minor pests infest and cause a severe yield loss. Okay, let us see which are the different pests which infest the tur crop or tur plantation. That is, in that here we can see in this slide there are the number of categories of pests which infest on the tur crop or pigeon pea crop. Here the first category is pod borer complex. The name itself indicate that these are the different pod borer pests like a gram pod borer, spotted pod borer, plume moth, spiny pod borer, blue butterfly and pod fly are the pests which directly cause a yield loss because they directly attack on the economic part of the plant, that is the pod or grain. Okay, then next category is pod bugs and green leaf hopper. These are the sucking pest. Okay, then next is a bird and flower feeder. In that, the blister beetle and the flower weber are the two important major pests of tur crop which attack on the bird and flowers of the tur. Then next one is a defoliator. These are the different pests like a Bihari caterpillar, leaf cutter bees, flea beetle and weevils are the pests which attack on the leaves and defoliate the plants. The next one is a leaf weber, and this is the another most important non-insect pest, that is the eriophyte mite, that is act as a vector for pigeon pea sterility mosaic virus and cause a severe yield loss in tur. Let us see one by one. Here this is the first and major pest of tur, that is Helicorpa armigera. It means that it is the pigeon pea pod borer and it is one of the mostly polyphagous pests which attack on number of host and causes severe yield loss. In pigeon pea is called as pigeon pea pod borer. It means that the caterpillar of the Helicorpa armigera attack on the developing pods or developing grains. If you see the life cycle of the red gram pod borer, that is the Helicorpa armigera, it is the one of the lepidopteran pest. Hence they have a complete metamorphosis and they have four different life stages: egg, larva, pupa and adult. After male female mating, the female moth lay their eggs on the tender parts of the plants. Then after hatching from the eggs, there are the number of caterpillars is emerge out because the egg laying is, or the fecundity rate of the Helicorpa is more. The caterpillar of this phase, it is the damaging stage. It is actually attack on the different plant parts. Then after the development of the caterpillar or the larva goes into the pupation, and the pupation occurs in soil as well as in leaf fold or pods and the crop debris. Then this is the typical characteristics of the caterpillar or the larva of the red gram pod borer or the Helicorpa armigera, that is the color variations. There are the different colors of the color variations. It from greenish to browns is occurs in the larvae of the Helicorpa armigera. Then I have already told you the Helicorpa armigera, it is the polyphagous pest. It means that it is so dangerous. So the question is, why is it so dangerous? These are the four major reasons behind this. That is, the first one is polyphagous in nature because they have a number of hosts. Near about 200 hosts is there. Then strong flying ability. The male female moth is very strong flying ability. Then faculty to diapause during summer condition. Hence the here the caterpillar of this or the larva of this pest, it is a have a faculty to diapause in case of summer condition. Then the high fecundity rate is also the one of the major reasons behind the Helicorpa armigera is the so dangerous. And then this is the most important facts about this pest. this caterpillar or the larva of Helicobacter armigera, how this larva is attacked in the field condition. Here, after the hatching from the egg, the caterpillar is feeding on the leaves and causing the defoliation in early stage. It means that the early instar larva of this pest is act as a defoliator. Then after that, after the flower formation, this caterpillar is also attack on the flower and flower buds. As a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the flower or the flower buds defoliate on the ground. Then after the pod formation, it attack on the pods by making a small circular holes on the surface of the pods and feeding in the developing grains of the pods. The one of the major characteristics of this pest is that during feeding or while feeding, the caterpillar enter their anterior half portion of their body inside the pods and the rest of the body hanging out. This is the one of the typical feeding habit of this pest. Then in this picture you can see here the larva feeds on the flower and flower buds and also feed on the pods. Here this is the typical characteristic symptoms or damage of symptoms produced due to the feeding of larva of Helicobacter armigera, that is the circular bore holes on the infested pods. Then now, how we can manage this pest in our field or in field condition? Before we going to the management of this pest, we should know about the ETL, means the economic threshold level of this pest. The ETL of this pest is that the 5 moth or the 5 adult moth per trap, or 2 eggs per plant or 1 larva per plant, then we can go for the management practices. First, that is the monitoring. Monitoring helps to check the pest population density, or the we can monitor the pest intensity of this pest intensity of Helicobacter armigera in the infested fields. For that purpose, we can install the pheromone traps, that is the sex pheromone trap with helilure at the rate of 5 traps per acre. Then in case of preventive measures, the summer deploying is should be possible, and this with the help of this summer deploying, the pupa of this Helicobacter armigera, it will be killed. Then the jawar and the sunflower, it is one of the two major intercrop we can use in the tour or with the help or within a tour to reduce the infestation of this pest. Then install bird perchers at the rate at the time of flowering at the rate of 50 bird perchers per hectare. Then timely sowing is should be helps to reduce the infestation of this pest. Then collection and destruction of grown-up larva. It means that we can collect the fourth and fifth instar larva from the infested fields and we can kill in the kerosinated water. Then in case of curative control, here the HANPV, it is one of the effective effective biopesticides, Helicobacter armigera nuclear polyatrosis virus, at the rate of 250 LE means larval equivalent. This is the very effective biopesticides against the Helicobacter armigera. Then no more really, it is one of the entomopathogenic fungus or biopesticides that is also effective against the caterpillar of the Helicobacter. Then Bacillus thuringiensis, it is one of the bacteria, that bacteria is also helps to reduce or to kill the larval instar of this pest. Then azadirachtin, this is the one of the botanical insecticides. That insecticide, it is nowadays mostly used to reduce the infestation of the caterpillar. Then these are the some of the chemical insecticides, that is the chlorantraniliprole, fluvendamide, imamectin benzoate, spinosad, novaloran and indoxacarb are the recommended insecticides we can spray with the help of these chemicals, pesticides for the control of Helicobacter armigera in tour crop with a recommended dose at a regular interval. Then next pest is spotted pod borer, or also called as Maruca. Maruca vitrata is the scientific name. It is also the one of the Lepidopteran pest. Here, this is the life cycle of Maruca or the spotted pod borer, also called as spotted pod weaver. After the male female mating, the female moth of the Maruka lay their eggs in the flowers or buds or on the pods. Then after the hatching from the eggs, the larva or the caterpillar emerge out, and the caterpillar or the larva, it is the damaging stage of the spotted pod borer. Then after, the larva goes into the pupation, and the pupation occurs in plant debris on the surface of ground. Then now, this is the nature of damage of Maruka. Here, the we can say that the peculiar or the typical symptoms of damage of the caterpillar of the Maruka is that webbing of flower is occurs. After the hatching from the eggs, the caterpillar web together the flowers and feed on them. Then also bore into the pods and feed on the seeds, resulting in appreciable loss in the yield of the seeds. And the number of boreholes we can see on the flower buds or buds on the pods, and the infested pods and flowers are webbed together. It means that here, when this pest is attacked on the pods by making a small bore holes in developing into the developing feed in the developing seeds, it means that as a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the seeds or the grains become unfit for human consumption and reduce the yield directly. Here in this picture, we can see there are the different instar of the larva of the Maruka, which is attack on the different plant parts. Here, the typical characteristic is that webbing of flowers is occurs in case of severe infestation of the Maruka. Then here we can see in this picture, when this caterpillar enter into the developing pods and feed on the developing grains, and the grains become unfit for human consumption, and in case of flower, webbing of flower is occurs. These are the different symptoms of damage or damage symptoms due to the feeding of the caterpillar of spotted pod borer. Then how we can manage this pest? In case of preventive control or preventive measures, the summer deploying, then you can use a bird perchers. Then in case of curative control, we can go for the 5% NSKE. The NSKE is the neem seed kernel extract. Then if you go for the chemical control, the propanophos, methomyl and chlorantraniliprole are the effective chemical pesticides against the spotted pod borer. Then next pest is tur pod fly. The name itself indicates that it is the fly, and near about all the fly, it is comes under the order of the diptera, and the damaging stage of this dipteran pest is called as the maggots. The Melanogramma obtusa is the scientific name of tur pod fly. This is the larva, and larva is also called as maggots, and maggots is nothing but the legless larva. This is the adult and the maggots of the Melanogramma obtusa. It means that it is a pod fly. Then it is a dipteran pest. They have a 4 different life stages: egg, larva, pupa and adult, and the larva is called as maggots. After the male female mating, the female fly lay their eggs inside the pod by piercing through the ovipositor or the pseudo ovipositor. Then after hatching from the eggs, the maggots is emerged out, and maggots it is feed in the developing grains of the tur pod. Then pupation is also occurs inside the pod. Then now, how these maggots it actually feeding in the field condition. After the hatching from the eggs, the maggots it enter into the soft seeds and feed on them by making a pin head size hole on the pods. And this is the typical characteristic symptoms of damage produced due to the feeding of the maggots by making a pin head size hole on the surface of infested pods, and it enter into the developing it enter into the pods and feed on the developing grains or seeds, and the seeds become unfit for human consumption. But at an initial stage, these maggots act as a leaf miner. It means that their galleries run just under the epidermis of the seeds, and by making the galleries under the epidermis of the seeds, later they burrow deep down, resulting in decaying of the grains, and the seeds become shriveled. The damaged seeds are unfit for consumption as well as for germination. Then in case of severe infestation, the pod present twisted in appearance, and the dark brown incrustation is seen on the pod wall or infested pod wall. These are the different characteristics or symptoms of the damage produced due to the feeding of maggot of the tour pod fly. Then in this slide or picture, we can see the pinhead size hole on the surface of infested pods. Then in second picture, you can see here the pupa on the maggots. It is feed on the developing grains and it become unfit for human consumption. Then in management practices for tour or red gram pod fly, the early sowing is possible. Then in case of curative control, the foliar application with the some of the chemicals like a thiamethoxam, imidacloprid, dimethoate, oxidimethan methyl, acephate or lambda cy halothrin or lufenuron with a recommended dose at a regular interval. The next pest is tour plume moth, Agdalastis atomosa. It is also the Lepidopteran pest. In this pest, the mark of identification is the one of the typical here. In that, if you see the moth of this tour plume moth, is that the four wings of the moth cut into the two parts and the hind wings into three parts with a fringe like border. Then if you see the caterpillar of this tour plume moth, is that it is a fringe with a short hairs and spines or spiny or hairy caterpillar. After the male female mating, the female moth lay their eggs on the tender shoots, loose flowers or the pods. And the pupation of this pest, it occurs on the pod surfaces or in the pod burrows. Then now, how this pest it directly damage into the field condition. Here the caterpillar is the damaging stage. The caterpillar make the hole into the pod opposite to seed developing inside and then insert its head into the pods and feeds on the developing seeds. It means that after the hatching from the eggs, the caterpillar of this tour plume moth making a small circular hole or irregular hole on the pods but opposite to seed developing insides and feeding in the developing grains. When one seed is finished, the larva cut another holes opposite to the another seeds and damage the seed. It means that this caterpillar of this tour plume moth is directly feeding on the grains. Hence, the yield is directly lost. The larva also feed on the flower buds and the small spiny or hairy caterpillars and the pupae seen on the pods. It means that in this picture, you can see here the pupa and the larva both are hairy in nature, which is present on the pod surfaces, and this is the typical damage of symptoms of this pest. Then for the management practices, we can use a bird purchase, then mechanical collection of the grown up larva which is present on the pod surfaces, then in case of botanical control, azadirachtin and NSK or neem oil we can use. Then here the Bacillus thuringiensis is also one of the effective bacteria or insect bacteria against the near about all the caterpillars. Then dimethoate, imamectin benzoate, indoxacarb, chlorantraniliprole and spinosad are the different recommended pesticides against the tour plume moth caterpillar. Then next pest is pod bugs. This is the one of the sucking pests of the near about all pulse crop. They have a two species. Pod bugs have a two species. The first one is Reporotus, Reporotus pedestris and Clavigera glibosa. Here, this is the Hemipteran pest. Hence, they have a incomplete metamorphosis. They have a three life stages: egg, nymphs, and adult. The female bug lay their eggs on the pods or leaves or on the buds. Then, after the hatching from the eggs, here the both nymphs and adult are the damaging stages of this pest. Here the both nymphs and adults suck the cells up from the tender shoots and also from the we can say that the pods, and as a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the pod it becomes shrivels and yield is directly reduced. This is the infestation or the damage symptoms which is produced by the feeding of nymphs and adults of the pod, sorry, pod bugs. And the pod become dry up and the seeds become shriveled and seeds it is unfit for human consumption. For the control of the pod sucking bug, we can control or we can manage the pod sucking bug with the help of the foliar application of the different chemical pesticides like thiamethoxam, imidacloprid, dimethoate, oxidimeton methyl and acephate. The next that is the eriophyte mite, Aseria kajani. This is the non-insect pest because it is not comes under the class of the insecta. We can say that this pest it is not comes under the class hexapoda or class insecta. They do not have a three pairs of legs, hence it is comes under the non-insect pest, but it is the major pest of the tur or red gram. Here this is also the sucking pest, hence they have a three life stages, egg, nymphs and adult. The egg laying of this pest it is takes place on the vegetative terminals, and then after hatching from the eggs the nymph is emerge out, and nymph and adult both are damaging stages. Both nymphs and adults suck the cells up from the leaves, and as a result of feeding the leaves become soft and lose their shape and mosaic in appearance, and instead of feeding the eriophyte mite in case of tur act as a vector for red gram sterility mosaic virus. Then in case of severe infestation the plant become without production of flowers and bushy appearance of the plant is occurs. Then in this picture we can see here the mosaic disease of the leaves and become chlorotic and the light green and most affected do not bear flowers. And then for management practices we can use acaricides or miticides, but before that we can use resistant varieties, and in case of miticides we can spray the crop with dicofol or wettable sulfur. And the most important practice is that avoid synthetic pyrethroids, because due to the continuous use of the synthetic pyrethroids they cause a resurgence after repeated spray of these pesticides. Then nowadays in market there are the number of the acaricides is there, that is the spiromycipane, then we can say that the abamectin benzoate is also, imamectin benzoate also used against this pest. Then next one it is the flower feeder, that is the blister beetle. There are the two major species, Lytta species and the Mylabris pustulata. It is the coleopteran pest. Here these are the two species, Mylabris pustulata and Lytta species. It is a coleopteran pest. They have four different life stages: egg, grub, pupa, adult. The female beetle lay their eggs inside the soil. After the hatching from the eggs the grubs is emerge out. The grubs is also present in the soil, but the one major characteristics or the major identification of this pest is that the grub of the blister beetle it is a beneficial in nature, because the grub it is feeding on the eggs of grasshoppers and locusts in the soil. It means that only adult is the damaging stage of this pest which infests the our crop plant. Then here in this picture you can see here these are the different blisters forms on the human skin. That is the reason behind this is that this is nothing but the blister beetle. How? When the blister beetle is rubbed with human skins it produces a one acidic yellow color substance, that substance or chemical substance called as cantharidin, and the cantharidin is responsible for the formation of blister on the human skins and hence known as the blister beetle. Here is also called as flower feeder, and the adult is only the damaging stage. In case of tur, the adult it is only attack on the flower parts. It is voraciously feeder on the buds and the flowers, and as a result of feeding the partial sterility is occurs and the pod do not develop well. And then for the management practices, and this is one of the major mechanical practices, we can collect the different beetles which is present in the infested fields and we can destroy in kerosinated water, or we can also go for the dusting with methyl parathion or malathion dust is also effective against the blister beetle. Then this is the blue butterfly, and these are the two species, they have two species. But here, these are the different life stages of the blue butterfly. The blue butterfly, it is the one of the minor pests of near about all the pulse crop. Here, in this picture, you can see the eggs, different larval instars. The larva of this blue butterfly, it also called as slug caterpillar. It look like a slug, hence known as a slug caterpillar. And the pupation, these are the pupa, and this is the adult butterfly. Here, this butterfly or the blue butterfly having the caterpillar, and the caterpillar is the damaging stage. Presence of slug like caterpillar on the plant parts is the signs of infestation. The caterpillar feed on the buds, flowers and young pods with bore holes. Then after that, the larva entry hole on the pods is plugged with excreta and honeydew secretion with the black ants movement. It means that this caterpillar look like a slug. It is just you can say that the crawling on the plant surfaces, and we can say that they produce the one of the honeydew like substance, and due to that substance the different ants is attract towards the caterpillars. Then this caterpillar attack on the different buds, flowers and pods, and this entry hole it is plugged with the excreta. Then for the management practices for the blue butterfly is that avoid dense and close planting, then avoid early or late sowing, then regular soil digging cause the death of the larvae and the pupae, because the larvae and pupae it is occurs in the soils. Then a trichogramma, it is one of the effective egg parasites against the blue butterfly. Then in case of chemical control, we can go for the spraying of the different chemicals like a chlorantraniliprole, spinosad, thiodicarb, imamectin benzoate, spinosad, like that. Then this is the leaf waver. This is also the minor pest. The name itself indicates that the caterpillar of this pest is wave the leaves and feeding inside. Here in this picture, you can see the caterpillar of this leaf waver larva waves the tender shoots and the leaves and feed within the conceal condition. For the management practices, we can spray the crop with chlorantraniliprole and the propenophos. These are the effective chemicals. These are the different major and minor pests of the tur crop which infest the tur. For this is the IPM, that is the integrated pest management. The how IPM it is used in the PGNP to control or to manage the different insect pest population in the red gram. Then here, why the IPM is must, why we need the IPM, because there are the some of the reason behind this. Several insects pests have developed insecticide resistance, then degradation of natural enemies due to the continuous use of the insecticides, then secondary pest outbreaks, then environmental pollution has become more persistent, then input on plant protection have increased enormously. Then these are the some of the IPM tactics you can use in the tur crop to reduce the pest infestation. That is the summer deploying, so adjust the sowing time, the intercropping and mixed cropping. Then we can use a bird purgers, removal of weeds, forecasting and monitoring, use of ovicides chemicals, then use of botanicals like NSK and chili plus garlic extract. We can use a HANPV for Helicor parmigiana, then we can use a safe insecticides, need based insecticide use, and the mechanical shaking of the plant. Here in case of the Helicor parmigiana, it is one of the so dangerous pest in near about all the crops. So the forecasting of the Helicor parmigiana based on the rainfall patterns. Here these are the conditions of the Helicor parmigiana, the how the incidence of the Helicor parmigiana is occurs. Here in this picture you can see here the if the total rainfall of the June and July and August September is more than normal rainfall of that period, then here in this slide you can see here the A plus signs indicate that the incidence of the this Helicor parmigiana is more at that month or in that month. Then in A minus condition, that is if the total rainfall of the June, July and August, September is less, and that is here this condition is occurs. If October rainfall is more than normal rainfall of that month, the here this is the B positive, it means that this is the low incidence of that pest. Then in case of B minus, if the October rainfall is less than normal rainfall of that month, the incidence is also the lower incidence. Then intercropping pattern, in case of intercropping, the sorghum, it is very effective intercrop with pigeon pea to reduce the infestation of the near about, we can say that the hill cover permaculture or near about all the pest. Then mixed cropping technique is also we can use. Then intercropping conserve the natural enemies. Near about all the intercrops, it is a cereal crop, and that cereal crop helps to increase the or helps to conserve the natural enemies in tur crop. Then these are the some of the techniques you can use to reduce the infestation of this pest, of this different pest in tur. That is the nipping at 50 days after sowing, reduce the height, induce more primary and secondary branches, plant protection measures become more easier, wider spacing reduce the produce pod borer incidence. Then in case of monitoring tools, there are the three techniques we can use: pheromone and light traps, visual counting of the eggs and larva, visual estimation of crop damage. This is the first method, that is the you can use a different sex pheromone trap, and this sex pheromone trap we can, with the help of the sex pheromone trap we can monitor the pest. Then second method is that visual observation of eggs and larvae on the different plant parts. Then if you go for the chemical control, in that chemical control, the first spray should be propenophos, thiodicarb and methomyls. That is the, we can say that the also called as the ovicidal chemicals. Then second spray with the help of botanical insecticides like 5% NSK or chili 0.5% plus garlic 0.25% extract or novaluron, that is the chemical insecticides, we can also use in second spray. Then in third spray we can go for the biopesticide like HANPV, that is the Helicor parmigera nucleal polyhydrosis viruses against the pod borer. Then this is also the third spray, that is HANPV or spinosad or imamectin benzoid. And then in case of fourth spray, chlorantraniliprole, flubendamide and indoxacarb, and also we can use. Then these are the some of the other management practices, that is the shaking of the plant. This is the one of the mechanical practices with the help of the shaking of plants. Here the labors shaking the tur plant and collect the collect the infested flowers along with the caterpillar of the Helicor parmigera. Then this is the last technique, that is the we can say that the bird perchers. With the help of this, the bird sit on that bird perchers and collect or pick up the different larval instar of the different pest. Here the sorghum is act as a live bird perchers and also the one of the effective intercrop. Okay, these are the pest management in the red gram or pigeon pea. Okay, thank you.